Hello, I'm Dr. David Kennedy, and I'll be your host for this amazing journey through the controversy and the truth about drinking water fluoridation. This is an 8-part series, and you're about to watch the first documentary that my wife and I shot in 1999. We're invited to China to the Fluoride Arsenic Conference, and the People's Republic of China Department of Endemic Disease Control was delighted to show us the tremendous improvement in the health of the citizens when they took fluoride out of the drinking water. Natural fluoride. Next up, the scientifically acclaimed documentary, China's Battle with Crippling Waters.
It's just 6 a.m. in Shenyang, China, and we're getting ready to go see an area of China that used to have crippling skeletal fluorosis. That's where fluoride in the water caused damage to the joints, particularly in the lower back, so that the people were crippled. The public health department improved the water supply and got fluoride out of the water, and they're going to show us a bunch of children who've grown up in this area that are now free of dental fluorosis, which is the first outward visible sign of fluoride poisoning, and introduce us to some of their parents and grandparents who've recovered partially from the crippling effects of fluoride. There are still 1.6 million people in China who are crippled by fluoride in the water supply. And well, we've got our fluoride tester here and gobs of little bottles, so we're going to sample the water and measure the levels that are now considered to be much better than before. See the name of the city?
Jinming City. We are going to talk with local public health officials. In the late 1970s, they discovered a high level of fluoride in the water in this village. With help from the government, they drilled a new well and built a system which delivered good water to their homes. He's explaining how the lower fluoride water has helped with their arthritis and the joint pain. Also, the economic health of the village is better. They can work, they can walk. Many people who were crippled before are now much better.
The pump, the jacuzzi furnace?
The tower of the water.
Water tower?
This tower was built in 1980.
What does it say over the door?
Tap water tower. Is that okay?
Very good.
Mr. Xie is the head of the school. Dr. Dong is showing you how the children's teeth look. If the children don't get dental fluorosis, then when they grow up, they're less likely to become crippled. Not as much dental fluorosis as before. These children are happy.
Yeah.
It was a really wonderful visit. Got lots of nice kids, and we're off. This is the one that's been corrected, where the well water has been improved, and there's no longer the dental fluorosis in the children, but there's still, of course, dental fluorosis in the adults.
Before the water treatment, she cannot get up, just lie on the bed. Oh. Now she can walk.
She can get up.
Yep. Grandson.
She's very...
She was not from this village and was not exposed to the high fluoride water until she married. Then she developed skeletal fluorosis. She was very seriously ill. She had to walk back over like this because of pain in her back. Serious skeletal fluorosis patient now gets better.
Let's go see.
She's 77 years old.
The knee bends? This is the new water that's improved the skeletal health. It's 77. She's better now than she was 10 years ago, 15 years ago. So she's pretty dramatic. Well, we've sampled quite a few waters today, and so now we're back in the hotel room, and it's time to see how much fluoride there is in the new well here at Shenyang in the province. We've got several samples. This is from the first lady we saw, the 55-year-old woman. We've measured that in our little colorimeter here, and it comes out to 0.48. And that's not great, but it's a whole lot better than the water that crippled her. We took another sample from the 77-year-old lady's house, and it came out 0.53. So they've got half a part per million in their water, and that they're doing better now.
Here we are at the train station, and the taxi left us off way over there. There we go.
And you know, the village we were going to, it's not open to the foreigners. So first, we need to get the permission from the Cifeng government.
Where are the escalators?
I'll show you our permission papers.
Thanks for the Mr. Gao Hongxin. He helped us get permission from Cifeng Department of Health and the Department of Policemen and the Department of Safety and the Department of Foreign Affairs. In fact, it's Hongshan District Foreign Affairs Office.
We're transiting from Chaoyang to Aohan in Inner Mongolia.
Thank you, and I want you to turn around and see the alternative modes of transportation that we have.
We are going to visit a village where we could not find water with low concentration of fluoride. Most of the houses have a well with high fluoride. The children are being poisoned by the water they drink. Many years ago, we discovered people here had crippling skeletal fluorosis. Some of the water supplies will change people's health.
The road to Alpak in Mongolia is under construction and in some places not very well paved.
Well, we survived Mr. Froggy's wild ride, and now we're deep in Inner Mongolia. After a good night's sleep and a little rest, we're ready to go out and see the area of China where they've had people crippled with fluoride in the water. It's natural fluoride. The level ranges between 4 and 9 parts per million. We'll take some water samples. You'll also get to meet the children that have dental fluorosis in the local school. We'll teach them how to brush their teeth, and we'll get to meet their parents as well. So, come on, let's get on the road.
What's the name of the school?
Central School.
Central School. All
right.
This afternoon, we will take the samples of the water.
时间非常充沛.
We have enough time.
Okay, good. And we got brushes in there, kids, and the camera.
These pupils are from 8 years old to 12 years old. Primary school. Notice how the children behave compared to the other school. They are not very happy.
Which color do you want?
This is how the children were in the first village before we changed the water.
Yeah, good. Push a little harder. Little circles. Right in. Push harder. Push.
These children have moderate to severe dental fluorosis. Chinese studies have found that the severely affected children have lower IQ than ones with less dental fluorosis. They linked high fluoride in the water with a marked decrease in IQ in children.
Number 9.
This implies that fluoride poisons their brains as well as their teeth. See how crooked the teeth are.
You can take 13 years old and 9 years old. 9.
Twelve years old.
And moderate fluorosis on the two front teeth, not more than 50%. There you are. See it? From school today, yes.
Her parents are already showing stage 2 skeletal fluorosis.
Watch mom come. Mom's got the tick-tock walk. Because the hips are gone and real stiff back. And come on. Everybody in this village seems to have.
His wife.
Yes.
She has knee and back problems.
The bony exostosis on the side of the knee, which is, makes it painful to bend.
Dr. Gao is showing you the bony knob on her knee, which makes her hurt to walk. Her father has lost mobility of his neck, bends over, and cannot straighten his arms.
in there.
This is her 58-year-old uncle. He has stage 2 skeletal problems, and his teeth show signs of dental fluorosis.
He's 69 years old and, as you can see, has difficulty in walking, has lost all of his teeth and can barely walk, and his wife is almost as bad. They walk like wind-up, tick-tock, clockwork dolls.
This man is 42 years old. He also has stage 2 skeletal fluorosis and has lost many of his teeth.
Come get the well.
At this house, we have a well which was not so bad. It is about 20 meters deep.
Yet another case. Dr. Gao has asked one of the severe dental and skeletal fluorosis patients to demonstrate how this disease progresses.
Dr. Gao is showing you how the patient cannot turn his wrist. Normally, you can reach all the way behind the head. He's showing how the neck and shoulders become. His back is bent like the others because of fluoride in the spine. Dental fluorosis makes teeth brown and wear off very fast. We can get a sample of his water.
Well, I'm letting you get out the primer stuff first.
Wait till.
Hit again.
During some of the earlier symptoms of skeletal fluorosis, his wife is more severely affected. She can't get up. She's paralyzed, and he says he cries every night for her. His back hurts a lot, and this is their humble abode. It's really sad.
The fluorosis just keeps her on the bed. She can barely move and is in severe pain night and day. She became paralyzed like this just 16 years. She cannot straighten her arms and her legs. She has not been able to get up for 4 years. This is an X-ray of fluorosis in the back. It causes lower back pain, so the person must bend over. The body cannot get rid of the fluoride, so it stores it in the bone. Abnormal bone tissue sticking out of the ankle.
Does that make it difficult to walk?
Yes. It hurts to move because the bone digs into the tissue and produces pain.
We're in another village, not too far from the other one, where they've changed the water. It's much better, not perfect, but it's a lot better than it was. In this village, there are no new cases of skeletal fluorosis. You can see that this village is much more prosperous than the other. Before the waters changed, it was as poor as the one we just visited. Lowering the fluoride in the waters dramatically improved the quality of life in this village.
We're going to take a sample of the new water and see how much fluoride still remains. The water's turned on twice a day so that people in each house can fill up their water jars. It's used for drinking and cooking, and the animals get to drink good water, too.
That's a great sound.
Before the water was changed, the average well was about 9 parts per million. Almost everyone suffered some effects of skeletal and dental fluorosis. We're going to show the children how to brush and, with permission, take some more pictures of their teeth to see how much dental fluorosis they still have. Most of the children's teeth show only very mild or mild, or even no dental fluorosis. This little girl has mild dental fluorosis.
You know, we didn't do the brushing thing yet.
Professor Dai's group has studied the problem.
The dental fluorosis prevalence was 37.8%.
At 1 ppm?
One ppm.
This patient is 58 years old. She became crippled and for 2 years could not get up. After the water was changed, the pain began to go away and she could get up off the bed. Her back is frozen in this position.
Ms. Chang, has she gotten any better since the new water?
Yeah, better. Better.
Better?
Better.
She's very grateful for the new water because her pain is much better.
2 years on the bed.
Thank you so much.
That is the best that she
this
can
do. The best she can get up.
This woman was also crippled, but now she can walk.
How old is she?
Her neck and shoulders still hurt a little. Age 15, she became crippled from leg pain. After 5 years on the bed, the water was changed and she got better. She's happily married and now has a son. She wants to show us her house.
Everyone in this village has a nice garden. Tomatoes, eggplants, corn. They use these melons just for the seeds that are laid out to dry in the sun. Sunflowers are a principal crop in this area, and they eat the seeds. They burn the stalks for heat in the winter. This is the end of the growing season, and they've put away plenty of food for the winter.
You don't have to open it. Oh. A staple.
It's tomato. How do you call this? For smoke.
Tobacco.
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 And this
for smoke,
is
tobacco.
Tobacco.
Bean. And then there's one open here.
Just
bean, black bean.
Oh, rice.
Rice.
And so black bean rice and tobacco and it's a black kazuki bean looks like and that this is cornmeal.
Corn powder.
Soup with the tea.
Yeah.
This is a main food called xiaomi or millet. This is where they cook and heat their home. They burn wood in this area.
Fire.
Research from the China Medical University found that water with lower fluoride helped the people's skeletal health, and now they can work to take care of their family.
We found that the 69-year-old man, say his name.
Chen Guangzhong,
had water that was 4.3 parts per million, and he developed crippling skeletal fluorosis several years ago. And in the United States today, it's legal to have water that's 4 parts per million, not different than this water here. So is the EPA correct that 4 parts per million water's safe? I don't think so. I think you need to let them know you don't think so either.
And so what did we learn from our research in China? We saw people crippled into poverty at levels of fluoride that are 4 to 9 milligrams a day. They were in pain, but the pain could be reduced if we lowered the fluoride from the water, but the crippling was permanent. The first outward visible sign of fluoride overdose is dental fluorosis, white and brown spots on the children's teeth. The Center for Disease Control has found that 30% of the children living in the artificially fluoridated areas of the United States have mild and very mild dental fluorosis. This is very mild dental fluorosis caused by drinking fluoridated tap water in San Francisco. This is very mild dental fluorosis caused by fluoride drops and tablets. Mild dental fluorosis is very ugly. Research in China has found that dental fluorosis is linked to lower IQ in children, neurological impairment. The state of California admits that water fluoridation will cause more dental fluorosis, but denies that it would cost the state anything because the state doesn't pay for cosmetic dentistry under welfare. We've learned once and for all that it is not a communist plot. The largest communist country in the world has literally hundreds of doctors and scientists trying desperately to lower their people's fluoride intake. In the United States today, the National Academy of Sciences has established an upper tolerable intake that's 2.5 times higher than you saw crippled the parents and ruined the children's teeth. Fluoride is not a beneficial element. It's a hazardous waste byproduct of the nuclear and phosphate fertilizer industries.